Hello everyone, welcome to this video lecture. Myself Dipali Wadkar, working as assistant professor at WIT Solapur. In this video lecture we will study light emitting diode LED. These are the learning outcomes. At the end of this video lecture, student will be able to examine working of LED. Student will be able to draw the VI characteristic of LED and applications of LED. Before going to LED, first we will see what is the light. The light is the type of energy that can be released by an atom. Light is made up of many small particles called photons. Photons having energy and momentum but no mass. The light emitting diode, that is the LED, it is an optical semiconductor device that convert electrical energy into light energy. So whenever the voltage is applied across this device emits the light. This is the real appearance of LED. The symbolic representation of LED, in that there are two terminals, anode and cathode. The symbolic representation is similar to the PN junction diode, only change that the arrow pointing outside from this diode. So this arrow indicates the light is being emitted from this device. Now LED construction. This is the constructional diagram of LED. It is surrounded by transparent hard plastic epoxy resin. Its shape is hemispherical. Due to this shape, the light is emitted uniformly in all directions. There are two metal electrodes, anode and cathode, which is used for external electric connection. Anode and cathode is connected by a small wire. There is one chip which is placed in reflective cavity. This chip consists P-type and N-type semiconductor materials. We will see how this structure of LED is made. Yes, there are three basic layers, P-type semiconductor, N-type semiconductor, and in between that active region, that is the depletion region. Okay. So the P-type semiconductor consists majority charge carrier holes, N-type semiconductor consists majority charge carrier electrons, and the depletion region consists immobile ions. The most of the photons emitted from this depletion region, so this region is called as an active region. LED operates in a forward biasing mode. So in forward biasing mode, the positive terminal of external supply is connected to the P-type semiconductor. Negative terminal of external DC source is connected to the N-type semiconductor. So whenever the battery connected in this way, the majority charge carrier electrons from N-type will repel towards the junction. So some of these electrons will recombine with the holes which are present in this depletion region to ions, that is at the positive ions. And some of the electrons will cross the junction and they will combine with the holes which are present in a P-side. Okay. Similarly, due to positive terminal, holes in a P-type semiconductor will repel towards the junction. Some of holes will combine with the electrons which are present at the depletion region, and some of holes will cross the junction and will recombine with the electrons which are present in a N-type semiconductor. So whenever there is a hole electron combination takes place, the photons emitted, that is the light emitted. So we'll see how this light is emitted whenever the recombination takes place. Yes. So electrons, pre-electrons present in a higher energy level, that is in a conduction band, and holes present in a lower energy level, that is in a valence band. So whenever the electron hole recombination takes place, these electrons jumps from higher energy level to the lower energy level. Okay. So the extra energy which is with this electron is released in the form of photons or in the form of light. Now here in LED, the materials which are used for this manufacturing of LED is a gallium arsenide or gallium phosphide. So these all these materials having the very large energy gap between the conduction band and valence band, and due to that the electrons jumps at a large distance and release the higher energy whose frequency is very high and which is visible to human eye. So whenever in this type of material whole electron combination takes place, the energy released, that energy is visible to the human eye. So light emits in case of these materials, that is in LED. In case of PN junction diode, that is whenever the material used like a silicon or germanium, in that case the energy gap between the valence band and conduction band, that energy gap is very small. So electrons jumps at a very small distance whenever there is a electron hole recombination takes place. So whenever there is a electron hole recombination takes place, electrons jumps at a very small distance and release energy. This energy is in the form of heat. So the photons which are emitted here, or the energy which is emitted here, that energy having very lower frequency, and that frequency is invisible to human eye. So in this type of material, silicon or germanium, whenever there is a electron hole recombination takes place, no any light emits or photons emitted here. So this is the basic difference between PN junction diode and LED. Intensity of light from LED, this intensity of light is depends upon the energy gap between the conduction band and valence band. If the large energy gap present, then the intensity of light emitted by that LED is also high. Okay? So as the energy gap between conduction band and valence band decreases, the intensity of light is also decreases. Now the question, what is the relation between forward current and light intensity? In the previous two slides we have seen the actually working of LED in forward biasing. So what is the relation between forward current and light intensity? Forward biasing, as the forward voltage increases, there are large number of hole electron combination takes place. Okay, and as the hole electron combination takes place, large number of photons emitted. So as forward voltage increases, light intensity also increases. So as the forward current increases, light intensity also increases. So there is a linear relation between forward current and light intensity or output light. Okay. Colors of LED. The material which is used for constructing LED, it determines its color. The wavelength or color of the emitted light depends on the forbidden gap or energy gap of the material. So these are the some examples of compound semiconductors which are used for the manufacturing LED. If gallium arsenide is used, then that LED will emit infrared. If gallium arsenide phosphide is used, then that LED will emit red light. If gallium arsenide phosphide with nitrate is used, it will emit yellow. If aluminium gallium phosphide is used, that LED will emit green light. If silicon carbide is used, that LED will be emit blue light. If gallium indium nitrate is used, that LED will emit white light. So in this way, for different combinations of these semiconductors, different colors of light is emitted by LED. There are number of applications of LED. Out of that, the one of the most important application, that is the 7-segment display. In the 7-segment display, the 7 LEDs arranged in a rectangular format. Here these 7 LED are connected by two way, either common cathode and common anode. In common cathode terminals of these all seven LEDs are connected together and they are connected to the ground. Okay. The segment which is to be on, that particular segment or that respective LED is get connected to the positive terminal. So one example, suppose we have to display one here. So respective segments for to display one, that is the B and C. So the LED which are present here, B and C, these LED get connected to the positive. So this LED becomes forward biasing and other remaining LEDs becomes reverse biasing. So this LED becomes on and emit a light. And due to this, here the display, that is that particular segment, this segment becomes emits the light. Now in common anode, the all anode terminals of these all seven LEDs are connected together and it is connected to the positive terminal. The segment which is to be displayed, that respective LED is get connected to the ground connection so that it becomes forward biased mode. Suppose we have to display one, then the B and C, the LED which are present here, these are get connected to the ground and all other LEDs remains off. Okay, so the LEDs which are present at the B and C becomes forward biased and they emit a light. Okay, so here one number is get displayed. So in this way, the seven segment display is used to display number from 0 to 9. Some more applications of LED. It is used in alarm system, calculators, picture phones, traffic signals, digital computers. It is also used in multimeters, microprocessors, digital watches, automotive heat lamps, camera flashes and aviation lighting. These are the references. Thank you.